Recording and we are streaming. Here we go. All right, everybody. Hello and welcome to the stream. If you are tuning in just now, which I doubt because I just started streaming, I don't really know exactly how to start streaming. Thinking about it. As you can see, I'm doing something a little different with my hair right now because it's really long and getting in my way. It's literally to the point where if I have it down, it will get into the ear cups of my thingy. So I'm kind of done with it. I pretty much just take it down for Zoom calls at this point. And even then, starting to get sick of that real fast. So here we are. How's everybody doing? People are doing all right, considering. As usual, give people a little bit of time to get in, catch up. Look at all of my weird things that I've got on here. What are these? I don't know what any of this. Yeah, oh, I see. Huh. Definitely looking at things I don't recognize. I clip anything right now. That's weird. Anyway, I thought about making a drink for this, but it is a Tuesday, and so I shouldn't. But I shouldn't. But I want to. It's a hard decision. I am not particularly excited about this game today because it's one of the scary ones and I don't like scary things at all. At all. So I'm nervous, I guess. Yeah. This is gonna be fine. It's only dark in this room. In my house for several weeks at this point, hardly leaving, not really talking to a lot of people regularly except for over the phone or on video chat, and so playing a scary game is definitely gonna feel something. We'll see. I did realize today that we did accidentally skip a game, so whether some of you consider it to be a game or not, I don't know. But we didn't do the Secrets Can Kill remastered, so I might blow through that one of these days, probably after this. I did, however, just figure out that this is the sixth to last fancy Jew game. Jeez, by the way, it sounds like it. I already had a drink. And so we're getting close to being done with these. After that, I have to retool exactly what I'm doing here. I have ideas, don't worry. Game's still gonna happen. Plenty of games in mind. Not gonna be any, like, big over-the-top ones, probably. Just gonna be, well, they're gonna be over-the-top, but they're not gonna be, like, you know, I'm not jumping into Fortnite, etc. It's gonna be more adventure games, I'm thinking. Some of the classics, because I, like, have never played Monkey Island. That'll be kind of interesting. So some of those, like, old Lucasfilm, Rose Arts ones will be fun. Yeah, it'll be fun. I forget what I was going to look up. I pulled up a browser window, and I don't remember why. I was looking directly at something. I don't remember. God. Oof. I don't remember at all. All right. Well, that'll either come to me or it won't. We'll see. Anywho, give a couple more minutes for people to filter in. While I stare and contemplate my life, trying to figure out what the heck I was going to look up. Remember. I really don't remember. Yeah. Yep, yeah, nope. I don't got it. Do not recall what it is. April Fools. Oh right, that's tomorrow, isn't it? Oh shit. I have assignments that I totally forgot about. Oh. We might have to end a little earlier than I thought. I'll have to take a look at that when I'm not on stream. Thank you for linking it though. Yeah, because I just, oh my god, I can't believe I completely forgot. I have like two assignments that are due tonight. I totally forgot about them. Wow. I think both of my professors are okay. Like, whoops. Assignment 3? Oh. Yeah, I am having a moment here where I feel like a total idiot and I'm suddenly nervous, but I should be okay still? Does it have a grade? Oh yeah. Oh yeah, I already saw this. Never mind. Okay, well, whoops. I done goofed. How bad is that? Close the chocolate. Shouldn't be eating too much chocolate right now. Had so much pasta for dinner. Oof, good morning. Wow, that was a lot. I'm tired of allergies. The last 2 weeks have been like an allergy fest. It's been great. Anybody else having problems with allergies right now? Because I'm certainly feeling it. There we go. See what we got. See, so this was going to be the year that I actually got the shots to, like, stop this from happening every year as bad as it does. And, well, you know, not a good time to go to the hospital for any of that, so I have to suffer instead. Which is, you know, fun. It wouldn't be quite so bad if it didn't have me questioning every single sneeze and cough and sore throat that I wake up with in the morning, but yeah, that's most of the struggle, if there is any at all. Other than that, it would have been fine. Yeah. So, oof. All right. Make sure I know what I'm doing with these assignments before I really get started, because somebody almost ruined my grade. Right. Let me just send this off real quick. Okay, sent. Keep an eye on my phone. Okay, and with that, we're gonna get started. All right, let me finish this and hope this works properly the first time. Well, went black on your end. Okay. Okay, I think we're working. Just turn it down a little bit more on my end. Hopefully, you guys can still hear. All right, let's get spooky because I'm ready for this. See how many times I scream.
What time is it? Anna? Is that you? What's wrong?
I got a case for you.
Can it wait until later?
I'm sorry, it can't. There's been a kidnapping. A girl just a little older than you.
Shouldn't the police be taking care of this?
There's only so much they can do, and she needs to be found before something bad happens.
What do you mean?
The call came in for me, but I can't go. Thornton Hall is a dangerous place for people like me.
Ghost
this
hunters, you mean?
A great time
so
to
people
call.
Think it's haunted?
Mm-mm. They know. Jesslyn needs someone who ain't afraid to run after her. That ain't me. What I'm asking of you is dangerous.
After everything you did for me in Japan, I'll do it.
Thank you. Drive to the airport now. I'll arrange a ticket.
He's right now.
I didn't call you just because you're a good detective. I called you because you're a skeptic. Thornton Hall is no place for anyone who believes.
Well, then you called the right detective.
I'm serious. You think long and hard about that before you get on that plane. If what you find on the island is going to get to you, don't go. Stay home.
Don't worry.
Can I stay home?
I'm on the case.
Sure.
You sure about this?
I am.
Watch yourself around the Thorntons. They earned their bad reputation.
Well, thanks for being concerned.
All right.
I should be okay.
Well, it depends who's here. Hope for your sake Wade's not skulking around, or that loony bin reject Harper. But it's Charlotte you best watch for. Blackrock Island belongs to her now. Has ever since the night the fire took her. Take care now.
All right. Well, here we go. Welcome to Thornton Hall.
Excuse me?
Sorry. Of course you're not. I'm just tired.
No, don't be. I'm Nancy.
You're here to help?
Savannah Woodham called me in. She seems to think there's a supernatural explanation to Jessalyn's disappearance.
A couple of days back, that would have earned an eye roll. I'm Colton, the fiancé. Welcome to Thornton Hall.
Suspect
I'd
number
extend
one.
You all the courtesies of the Thornton clan, but we seem to be about 20 years too late for that. You might need this. I found it in the house.
Is this Jesslyn's?
Yeah. It's dead, though. And the charger got mangled by something. Maybe you could channel all that inquisitive energy into seeing if you can get that old phone back up and running.
I'm feeling some sass from this picture.
Are you and Jocelyn getting married soon?
Yes.
Any chance this is just pre-wedding jitters?
You take your peroxide blonde head.
Trust me, everyone does. But she never let anyone worry about her like this. She loved her family more than anything.
Is it safe to assume you had second thoughts about the wedding?
I never said that.
True, but you implied it. You said, trust me, everyone does.
I know. I remember it like it was just moments ago.
Because it was.
Later.
I don't need the sass, bitch. Excuse me. And Nancy Kleptomaniac begins.
You must be Nancy.
Yes, you must be Clara, Jessalyn's mother.
Yes.
I want you to know that I'm here to help you with anything you need.
That's real sweet, hon.
I know you may not want me here since you didn't actually call me yourself.
So long as you help me find Jessalyn, you're welcome under what's left of my roof here.
Who did Jessalyn come here with?
Addison. I tried talking to her, but she was a wreck. Here. She'll have calmed down a bit by now.
Everyone's so helpful.
What do you think happened to Jessalyn?
You wouldn't know by the look of this dump, but we're worth a great deal of money. Well, that's what I thought this was. But then, no. Not yet, at least. I can't believe I'm praying for a ransom note to show up. It's like someone's trying to punish us.
Why do you say that?
Thornton Hall was once something truly beautiful. But so much greed and tragedy built up in these walls that when they started to crumble, I wanted to save this place. Make it mine. But I couldn't. So whoever took Jessie wanted us to sit here in this broken down old house waiting for her.
An old, wealthy southern family with a plantation. And are we gonna get around to that subject at all?
Cold feet?
My Jessie would never put her family through this nightmare, never.
Were things good between Colton and Jessalyn?
They had their rows and their romantic dinners, same as any couple. Colton had some... Well, hon, he had some issues, but they worked through them.
Issue? You mentioned that Colton had some issues.
Infidelity?
What did you mean?
To put it delicately, family or issues. That. Never you mind, it has nothing to do with what's going on now.
Are you sure?
Why is everyone here? Shouldn't we be out searching for Jessalyn?
I closed down the company. The entire staff is out combing the woods. I said, sit home or join the search. You get paid right? Either way. Not a soul stayed home. Jessalyn grew up in the business. She's got a lot of people looking out for her. I can be thankful for that. The police recommended a presence here. They said we'd have a better chance of noticing if something was off here, knowing the place and all.
See you later.
Take care.
Well, is something off here? It certainly looks like it. Miriam Thornton. Espionage in a bonnet. Female secret agents of the Civil War. Marion Tubman. Belle Boyd. Rose Carino. Nothing particularly... In order to keep a close watch on the production facility, Jeb had built a small factory on the Blackrock property. He did not foresee potentially disastrous possibilities. The workers were granted permission to stay overnight in the factory. None survived. Workers? Workers? What kind of workers? We have sown the black seeds of death, and forevermore will harvest only blood. Oof! that this is just a negative. It's not even... Yeah, it's just a negative. That piano. Yikes.
I already have one.
Hey, right. We're good. Had some tea. Let's start on the first floor. Make it obvious. Serpentine, okay. Picking it up, aren't we? One copper coin and one nail into each fruit. Connect all the fruit together in a row by attaching positive terminal clip to nail in one fruit and the opposite negative terminal clip to the coin in another fruit. Alright, well.
I don't have all the parts I need.
Yep, not yet.
This looks like a painting. I should find somewhere to place it.
Alright, we ready to see something creepy? How about this? Yeah. Yeah, this is... something. There's a cotton gin. Yeah, if it's not obvious that we're talking about a bunch of... The thing where, okay, yeah, we got some pennies. A family where the factory was for cotton and all of their enslaved peoples died? Yeah, no, we're talking about. Thornton family cotton processing. This door is from the barn that housed the equipment for processing the cotton. Many a worker lost their fingers in the processing room. But we're going to carefully say worker and not say enslaved person. Woof. This is going to be a fun game. Take everything that isn't nailed down, though. Ooh, Jesus Christ. Ha! That happens a lot, by the way. And so those little moments of me getting scared are going to happen a lot. Fuck. This is going to be so fun. By fun, I mean terrifying.
It looks like the painting is missing.
Well. That looks right. Yes, right? Well, we have cotton. Nothing new. There we go. I have stuff about all of the people here. Well, they died. That's comforting. Right, as long as they don't say that, then I'll be a little less apoplectic, but only a little less.
What's that smudge? It almost looks like something was painted over.
And keep wiping it.
What is that? Are those graves?
And who is that, more importantly? Well, that's a door that needs to be unlocked at some point before. Right. What creepy thing is going to happen when I turn the corner now? Nothing yet? Okay.
Hello.
What's the story with a locked room upstairs?
It's Charlotte's. We don't go in there.
It might help me figure out what's going on, if I could take a look around.
Best of luck. That door locked itself up tight the day of her funeral. There's not a key in this world that'll open it. I've tried.
Who else was in that old portrait with you?
You know, hon, we had that covered up for a reason. I can't talk about it. Not right now. Please, just leave me be.
Oh, okay.
What's up?
What do you think of Clara?
She's just a little severe until you get to know her.
And then?
I wouldn't know.
She does seem a little tough to get to know.
I think it's an act.
Yeah,
come right down to
definitely
it.
Had a nerve
she
with her.
She keeps the family and the company from falling apart. She can't afford to look weak.
How did you and Jessalyn meet?
I saw her one day and thought, this is the girl I'm going to marry. And then I threw a rock at her face.
Like, metaphorically?
No, I was just a kid. I had a very limited game book. She still has a little scar. You can see it when she smiles. I'll never.
An act of true love.
I imagine things improved from there.
We became best friends. Then we grew up and became what we are. Or were. Or.
So you and Jessalyn must have dated
like
for quite some time.
He is double.
Actually, didn't
about
start
it.
Dating until a year ago.
Probably because
really?
He's.
We both dated other people, but nothing worked out. One day, Clara had enough and sat us down and said, everyone knows you're going to get married. Go to it already. Jess was mortified. I took her out to the coast since that always cheered her up. We talked through the night, and by the time the sun came up, it just stopped sounding so silly.
I'd better get going.
Bye.
This feels a little, something. Like, sure. All right. Well, start calling people.
Addison, my name is Nancy Drew. I'm calling to see if you can help me with something.
Is this about Jessalyn?
Yes.
I can't. I'm sorry.
The sooner we can find out what happened to her, the better her chances of survival.
Yeah, bitch.
Okay. I'll help with what I can.
Talk to me.
How's Jessalyn's relationship with Clara?
Okay, maybe a little strained.
How so?
Jess used to call her Chairman Mom. Behind her back, of course.
Do you think Clara could have anything to do with Jessalyn going missing?
I don't think Jess was afraid of Clara. But still, I can't say for sure.
What do you think of Colton?
What's to think? He's always been decent to me and Jess.
He's such a blank slate that I don't think anything about him.
Can you walk me through what happened the night Jessalyn went missing?
She was about to get married, and I think the pressure of it was getting to her. It was supposed to be a night of blowing off some steam. Jess always loved a good scare. She used to make me sneak into scary movies with her when we were kids. So, in a weird way, spending the night searching for a ghost sort of made sense for a bachelorette party. At first, it was really fun. We were running around trying to scare ourselves silly. We were making these recordings like we were on a ghost hunter show. Then, things got strange.
Is there anything you remember that might help me find Jessalyn?
No. Actually, wait. Hang on. Upstairs, there was this door. Jess was desperate to get it open. Between you and me, I was relieved that she couldn't figure it out.
Really? Why?
I could feel eyes on me all night long.
What were you doing at Thornton Hall that night?
A scavenger hunt, but I don't know. There was something strange about it.
In what way?
Jess was looking for something toward the end of the night. Kind of desperately. It stopped being fun. That's all I know.
Hmm.
How was Jessalyn acting that night?
She was classic Jess for most of the night.
Then something happened?
Yeah. We were in the house and suddenly she just screams. And then she's nowhere to be found.
What happened?
I was alone in the house, jumping at every noise, too afraid to move. It felt like hours. Then she came back. She wouldn't say what had happened. She wouldn't even talk to me. She wanted to be left alone. She went downstairs, and that was that.
You said things got strange. What did you mean?
This is something.
It was her and me up in that freezing house, and I remember thinking, I'll never get to sleep. But then I started to feel fuzzy.
Fuzzy?
Like I was underwater or something. And I noticed Jess was gone again. I wanted to get up and find her, but I couldn't move. It was like this invisible hand was pinning me down. I heard a strange voice. It wasn't Jess. Then it was the morning. I was alone and Jess was gone.
You said you heard a voice.
Charlotte. I'm sure of it.
Did she say anything?
She sang. I only heard a little bit.
Would you consider yourself a believer in the paranormal?
If you'd asked that last week, I would have made some crack about Bigfoot.
And now?
And now I'm going to say that I don't believe. Because I'm afraid if I let myself believe, I'll be opening a door that no one can close.
Did you notice any secret passages?
All right, we're all
going to
calm down a little bit here, right?
The house?
No, but it was so drafty in there, it would surprise me if there weren't.
See you later.
All right, later.
Oh, that's all that.
Haven't done that.
All right, let's call Bess.
Bess's phone.
All right, Ned. Bonus Ned. What are you two up to?
George is in New York.
So, she got the internship with that Technology of Tomorrow place?
Yeah, Ned and I were just planning a road trip for when you're back. I was in the middle of trying to convince Ned to grow a bad mustache so we can hang out in Brooklyn.
Not going to happen.
Someone has to, Ned, and George already said no. It was a really angry no, too. Anyway, did you make it to the island?
I did.
I've been doing a little research, and I can see why Savannah sent you.
Why's that?
If I believed in ghosts, I wouldn't come within a few hundred miles of Black Rock Island.
Here we go.
I can definitely see why.
Yep,
Even
Ned's
I
to
have
her.
To admit it does have a certain abyss gaze is also into you vibe to it.
Put that on a billboard.
I've got your back. I've been reading up on missing persons cases and hauntings.
And hauntings.
Really? Oh, that's great.
I've been watching videos of otters. So good at stacking things. Additionally, I've kidnapped Ned. I've been so bored since George left, and Ned's a very active listener.
Mm-hmm.
See? And he's also very quick to Stockholm.
Nickerson family trait. We like being liked.
Oh, thanks, you two.
Nickerson family trait. I'm a pushover.
Odd. I want to catch you up on the case.
So it's a missing persons case, right?
Do you think he's actually missing?
I don't know. I've heard of runaway brides, but I don't think that's the case.
If it's a missing persons case, why aren't the police taking care of it?
Well, they are, but since she's an adult, there's only so much they can do.
Ned was telling me about the ghosts out there. Do you think maybe they're related?
Actually, I believe in this ghost.
Ned, do I have permission to do a spit take in your living room?
No.
I'm doing it anyway. Say that again.
Whoa, stand down, Bess. The Nickersons are a tidy people.
I wasn't really gonna do it, guys. Unless someone
takes a drink.
And this is a red soda that's still on the market, even though it's been linked to distractibility in 9 out of 10 Besses. Back to you. Are you finally trading in your Skeptics Club card?
And miss the dinner that probably won't happen this year? No way. People here believe in the ghost.
All these jokes.
I don't take the ghost story
as good as it gets, kids.
Seriously, I might miss something.
Smart.
Well, I hope so. I need to charge a phone that has no charger.
I'm not good with koans. Ned?
Oh, I got this. I once made a potato battery by hooking up some wires.
Yeah, well, I once turned a potato into an abomination by forgetting about it for a year. Sorry. It's hard not to get jealous around Mr. Knows Things here. Continue being useful.
Actually, that's all I've got. If you find some potatoes or oranges and some alligator clips, that might get you part of the way there.
I met Jessalyn's mom.
Poor her.
Assuming she's innocent, what's your impression?
She's reserved.
That's a nice way of putting
it. But it does make her hard to read.
She is stone cold.
But I have owned my fair share of fish. And no way anyone could take care of something.
I wouldn't go that far. She hasn't been hostile.
Nancy, it's too sad. Can't do it.
I owe it to Jessalyn to distrust everyone, even her.
I know. This case is like a big, fat, tall cloud of sadness that's sitting in front of me and using its cell phone when it's not supposed to.
We just got back from a pretty rowdy opening night screening of the Relation Shipwreck. It was really bad.
All I want is to see the screen and to not deal with jerks, to have a movie-style romance, and for no one to get hurt ever. Find her, Nancy.
I'll do my
find
best.
Find her, Nancy.
Promise. I met Jessalyn's fiancé, Colton.
Where's he fall on the cute...
I think it's supposed to be a...
That's not a valid
movie
spectrum.
Title.
Like fun it isn't. Oh, is this because Ned is on the line?
No.
I'm not calling off the dogs. You're just going to have to find a way to tell me that balances the public's need to know with Ned's presumably fragile ego.
My ego is perfectly fine.
Is that so?
Nickerson men laugh in the face of insecurity.
That's so, Neddard? Attest.
Neddard.
Describe Colton's looks using the International Ned Cuteness Unit. We talking half a Ned? Two Neds?
Alright, I'm gonna leave this one up to you guys. 1/10 of a Ned, 10 Neds, or I don't want to do that. How mean are we to whoever? We're talking about Colton here, who is not a nice person. But we're also talking about Nedstifer. But also decline, but like, what fun's that, right? What fun is that? That's the thing, he's not as bad as 1/10 of a Ned, but like, is he 10 Neds? I mean, I don't know much more about his personality. Doesn't necessarily help or hurt him at all. Yeah. They're both bland. Nah, it's not worth it. I just kind of want to bruise Ned's ego a little. They are really white bread with American cheese and I absolutely. Maybe a little bit of ketchup in there as well. That's about it. Deep fried, served with French fries that are like shoestring and too dry. You know what?
I don't want to do that.
That good looking? Yikes.
Woo!
That's not the important part.
Right. Ticking clock, kidnapping, etc. How guilty does he seem? For consistency, please state your answers in Ned units.
I couldn't tell you yet. He doesn't seem as worried as I'd expect, but maybe he's the type to internalize his feelings.
Huh. So that's a thing you can do?
The boyfriend is statistically favored when it comes to crimes like this. Try to get him talking about the relationship. I studied that in preschool.
See you later.
I studied
Bye.
That in preschool? What the fuck, dude? Oof. Alright, we gotta change this. That's not creepy at all. Okay. Yeah, that's good.
Yes?
I'd better get going.
Take care.
Take care now.
Hi.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye now. Y'all take care now, you hear? Alright, well, let's go back out into this very creepy thing to, scavenger list. Here we go. Let's go to the cemetery, because that's going to be a safe place to go, right?
Hey! Yes. You're not Savannah.
No, but you must be Wade.
Is she with you? Are you the new assistant? What's his name, get canned or something?
Logan? I don't know. All I know is that she thought I'd be the right person for the case. She's not coming.
What did you just say?
She said she was sorry to send me, but nothing could get her to come here.
I never took her for a coward.
Well, she seemed pretty scared of the ghosts.
Ghosts? No, that ain't it. She's scared of seeing me.
We're just gonna walk off with that.
Savannah understands the mess she dropped you in.
What kind of mess?
Take a look around and then you tell me. Who's more welcome here? The living or the dead? Anyway, Savannah had a package sent. I guess it must be for you. It's up in the house.
From what I understand, the Thornton family business is very successful.
Yep. We got money and all the trouble that buys.
Who else is here?
Clara. That's Jesselyn's mother. Colton, her fiancé.
Anyone else?
Depends what you mean by anyone.
Any other alive or verifiably real people?
No.
Good qualifications.
What do you think of Colton?
I do not like that shifty little punk, but I have said that about all Jesse's boyfriends. With him, I mean it a little extra. Something's crooked with the two of them together. I don't know if she can see it or not.
Who runs the family company?
Clara.
Do you think that's fair?
No.
Would you like to run the company?
Good sweet nonsense, no. Do not even imply that I'm after that to anyone.
Okay.
Why aren't you in the house?
I'm only on the island because Jesselyn's missing. Nothing's gonna get me in that house.
What's Clara's relationship to the rest of the family?
My cousin. Hopper and Charlotte's cousin. She lived with the girls after her mama passed.
Do you know Savannah?
I did, once.
And now?
And now I don't.
How did you meet Savannah?
We went to the same bookstore.
You don't seem like the type.
I'll take that as a compliment and an insult.
It's
How long ago was this?
A while. Gone now. It was a little old dark place. Carried these musty old books. Stuff that didn't exist anywhere else.
What kind of stuff?
All sorts. But I was there researching our family. Savannah had this way of reading. Like there was something she needed to know real bad. One day I finally asked, what is it you need to know so bad? You know what she said?
What?
Nothing. She handed over the book she was reading and walked out. At first, I'm feeling a touch rejected. But then I look at the book.
What was the book?
That was the crazy thing. It was the Thornton family book of names. Births, deaths, marriage, and so on, going way back.
Why would she have that?
Why indeed? I had to know. Took me some doing, but I tracked her down.
So you met Savannah because she was trying to find Charlotte's ghost?
One of those people who met her was Savannah. Ask her, and maybe she'll tell you about it. After that, she became obsessed with Thornton Hall. We got to know each other. I fell for her like a Black Tuesday banker.
There it is.
In the end, the landing was just as rough.
You said you were researching the family. Why?
After Charlotte died, that's when something I always knew came out shining so bright, I finally had to admit it. Long as it's been growing, the Thornton family tree's been split down the middle. The evil roots always trying to strangle out the good. I used to think I was on the side of good.
And now?
What do you think?
I don't know.
Yep, same here.
What did you mean about the family being split in two?
You wouldn't know by looking around here, seeing the state we're in, but we're loaded.
What's that have to do with anything?
The Thornton family bought its money with blood, and not always our own.
And
Slavery.
You think one part of the family have more to do with this than the other?
I don't speak ill of the dead, especially not when they're staring up at the soles of my boots. Look around. You'll see.
Does anyone actually live here?
No one lives out on the island, but just on the shore.
Were you close to Jessalyn?
Everyone was. Everyone is. She's the bright spot of happiness in this whole miserable family.
Goodbye.
Bye. No need to jump, just me.
Can you tell me about some of these stones?
I'll tell you what I can. But sometimes it's best to just look and listen. That there is Clara's mother.
What can you tell me about her?
Not a great deal. She loved her secrets. Never even told Clara who her daddy was.
Why not?
Don't know. When Clara was about 10, Rosalie got real sick. Every day, Clara would ask about her daddy. I think she was afraid of being left to fend for herself. But Rosalie wouldn't say. Harper's stone.
Harper?
Indeed. She ran away shortly after Charlotte died. Long enough that we thought we'd lost her too. One day she walked in the front door looking wild and thin as a spring sapling. Never said where she was. Her granddaddy was so mad he left the stone to remind her of what she'd put them through. She'd sit out there and read. Don't know if it was spite or if it made her feel at home. Knowing her, probably both.
The family already?
This blank one is my favorite.
Why is that?
Who doesn't want a celebrity in the family? Especially one that rubs all the wrong people the wrong way. The Gray Lady. In the Civil War, they say she was a spy, passing codes for the North. If you look, you can find some of her contraptions here. Mm. Her service gave the Thornton family this land.
All right. Well, we have a southern family that has lots of money, but a plantation after the Civil War?
That's Charlotte.
Dear sweet Charlotte, please come back. That's a sad inscription.
It was a sad time. None of us wanted to see her leave. We didn't expect it to become what it's become. Beauregard Thornton. Mean old codger.
That's it. That's the tweet. Alright, well.
Virginia, my mother. Rest her soul.
Can you tell me anything about her?
Just that I miss her. And I always will.
Animal Crossing is a much...
Luther. My daddy.
Like,
Mama called him the king.
Calmer game
door.
Than this, so.
He had a hot temper.
I envy you
a
little
soft
bit.
Heart, and no mind for business. He wasn't intuitive. He brought me out here to the stones at night. Taught me how to open my eyes, shut up, and listen. You rest well, Daddy.
Well then, this has been a lovely time. Well, okay. Final recipe on the family grounds, including Franklin Thornton defending his nation, 1918. Okay, I'll take it.
Roger and Marie, side by side from the day they married to the day they died. Both real sweet. Charlotte and Harper's parents, may they rest in peace.
It's locked.
Of course it is. Four souls. That's dark. Well, cheerful visit to the cemetery. Always a fun time. Let's go back to the house that's haunted.
What do you think happened to Jessalyn?
They are very DED.
I'm trying to avoid thinking about it. I have a... My mind can get caught up in a real dark place. You know, when things around me get bad.
That's called depression.
What do you mean?
Ignore me. I've been up way too long.
Do you know anything about Clara's past?
No. It's funny you ask.
Why is that?
I could tell Jess had something to tell me about Clara. She'd get so close and just stop dead.
She never told you anything?
I know Clara's mom died when she was young, and she ended up living with her cousin's family. But that's it.
I'd better get going.
Goodbye.
Hello.
Is there anything else I should know that might help me find Jessalyn?
Yeah. Keep a suspicious eye on Wade.
Wade didn't seem all that dangerous to me.
He neglected to tell you about his time spent in jail, I see.
As a matter of fact...
Wade's a nice guy when he wants to be. And only when he wants to be. I'm happy we have another set of eyes looking for Jesse. But I do hope you know what you're getting yourself into.
Everyone else seems to be avoiding
the
house.
I feel like I'm getting myself into a massive family drama moment.
Not after the day I've had.
Fair enough. I guess I want to be close to whatever it is that took Jessalyn.
See you later.
Bye.
So cheery. Bye. During the day, but night is the best time to investigate the family. That's when the spirits grow restless in more ways than one. You'll probably get more out of the family then anyway. EMF gadget I worked included pretty well on the property. I don't normally use these, but there's a strong correlation between the meter peaking and documented sightings. No, you don't like things that can't be explained, but just because it can't be explained yet doesn't mean you should disregard it. Call me if you want to talk. I don't know what help I can offer, but I'm there if you need. Here we go. Subject Swimmer. Notes near death. Just swim over. Sure. Okay. These are creepy. Do you know? Yeah. Do you know what you've gotten yourself into? No, that's why I'm here. Oh, God. We haven't given Savannah a call yet, so let's give Savannah a call.
Hi, Nancy.
Hi, Nancy.
Yes.
I think they're silly, but apparently some of the people I've met swear by using EMF signatures on the property.
Hi, Nancy.
What have you been up to since we spoke last?
I've been teaching the road to know my wheels.
Are you working on the next book?
I've been running away from the next book. And an empty house that was filling up with chatty ghosts. But who knows? When I'm out of gas, maybe I'll have no choice but to listen to what
I know.
They have.
It's back. It's back, baby.
I'll send you a gallery proof. If they're not, guess I'll go teach.
Do you know anything about the factory accident?
Nothing I can verify. It's been scratched out of the local history. When I was there, I expected to feel something when I stood near the old factory.
And nothing?
As many spirits as I expected. I only met one.
Charlotte?
That'd be the one. Dear sweet Charlotte, the terror of Black Rock Island.
I spoke to Wade.
I figured that might happen eventually. Can I explain, or are we beyond that?
I'm sure you have your reasons.
I do.
Wade said he was expecting you. Why didn't you tell me that?
I was going to come. I meant it when I told him I was coming.
But then?
Then I got scared.
What scared you away from taking the case?
To be blunt, the living Thorntons are just as scary as the dead ones.
Truth.
Why?
They've dug so many graves on that rock that death himself is on the Christmas card list.
I know, right?
I can't help but wonder if they're misfortunate fools or just addicted to Sunday clothes and the sound of a spade taking a bite out of cold clay.
Oof.
Goodbye.
These images. They are dark.
What's up?
The bedroom key is crossed out in the scavenger hunt. Do you know where it is?
No. Jessalyn must have found it, but I couldn't tell you where it is.
See you later.
Find Jess.
Okay, well, keep moving. Know what we're doing next? Honestly, I don't actually know. And this place has tools and stuff. I think there would be nails in here. So I could finish that one thing. But I haven't found nails, so not sure. God, I hate this room. Every time I turn this corner, I'm expecting something terrible to happen. Totally expecting.
That didn't sound good.
I'm gonna just not fuss with that anymore. I think she might just die. Yeah, this is not liking me, is it?
Can't do that right now.
Hello.
I'd better get going.
Take care.
She does, doesn't she?
What's up?
Bless See you your
later.
Heart.
Later.
Bless your sweet little heart. Honey. Hun. Sorry. Hun. Oh, Jesus, hi.
What was that?
Yeah, it's not even that high. Not even that bad. Can I just see? No. I already know that this is useless right now.
Yes?
I saw something really strange.
I did too.
What do you think that was?
Excuse me, I need to be alone.
Hey. Also, can we just talk about the fact that, you know, Charlotte very likely died in, like, the 80s or something? But her ghost is wearing a Civil War gown?
Ha!
Goodbye.
Bye.
Not sure why.
Want to hear a ghost? Check it out.
Do people really come here trying to meet Charlotte's ghost?
Around the time Charlotte's ghost was driving the family away, the stories started to spread. Little kids around here started playing this game to scare themselves silly. They'd turn off the lights and say, "Fire so red, night so black. Dear sweet Charlotte, please come back," over and over again until they just about scare themselves to death. It was just a game, but that's when people started jumping the fence at night hoping to meet her, saying that same silly rhyme. Most would just come and go in peace, but the ones who found her, it messed them up real good. A couple even went into shock.
Is it true that you have a questionable past?
You asking if I really went to jail? Yes, I advise against it.
Why?
It's not a fun place, and they don't let you leave.
Boom-sh.
No, I mean, why did you go to jail?
I know. I was arrested a couple years ago. All right, like...
I took a tour of the seasons. My debt is paid, that's all.
I'd really like to know.
The nerve you got.
Can I listen to more recordings?
Sure.
It doesn't really sound ghost, it sounds more alien.
Savannah said Charlotte was supposedly a ghost.
Not supposedly.
In my experience, ghosts tend to be not real.
Then consider yourself lucky. In my experience, of which I have significantly more, reality isn't that simple.
Have you ever actually seen this ghost?
This ghost was my cousin Charlotte, and yes, I saw her. I saw her grow up. I was here the night she died, and I've seen her since, much as I wish that wasn't true.
I saw something I can't explain in the house.
That's why you couldn't get me in there for nothing.
I don't believe in ghosts, but...
That don't stop you from feeling them. Would you believe my happiest memories live in that house? Christmases and long summer nights stargazing on the roof.
I found a set of graves without names on the markers.
That is where our troubles began.
What happened?
Most of the family had rather it never come up. Our first factory was right here on the island. At the time, it made us a lot of money. But along the way, we got greedy. Never built a place for the workers to stay. They'd bed down right on the processing floor. Nothing for heat in the winter, so the workers built fires inside. One winter, there was a wicked cold snap. They built a couple of extra big fires, and in the night, the fumes built up. None of them ever woke up again. That's when we split in two. Half saying this'll never happen again, and half saying accidents happen. Grieve and move on.
Have you always been a ghost hunting enthusiast?
I'm not exactly enthusiastic about the dead, no offense meant. But yes, I do find it interesting.
Why?
Life is a quest for truth, is it not? And death has a way of stripping away all pretensions.
That's pretty philosophical for a guy wearing boots.
I don't get that line.
You Northerners don't have a lock on big thinkers. We got plenty. Like Roscoe J. Redbrook and the Gimbletucky Boys. And I dare you to say their lyrics don't equal those of the Greek poets.
Sure.
And we got that old guy with the white suit and the chickens. Point is, I like ghosts because they show me what is, not what I want to see. And wearing boots don't make you stupid. Makes you smart if it's muddy.
If it's muddy. Can Colonel Sanders is Aristotle? I mean, I don't want to turn this into a shit on Southerners fest, but, like, this guy is not a good representation.
Do you have a key to the crypts?
Sorry.
When did the factory accident happen?
That was more than 100 years ago, and we still can't move on. That's why this house still stands, I think. Until we Thorntons decide who we're gonna be, we're stuck on this island. You should see it on a summer day when the ocean and the sky are sharing the same blue and the grass is bright. But here it is, gray and dark, under all the misery we've heaped upon it.
You don't seem like a bad guy. Can you tell me why you ended up in jail?
You really want to know?
Yes, goddammit.
Then listen. I don't care if you believe me, but keep this to yourself.
Okay.
I wasn't close to the company then. Still ain't, but I heard through a friend of the guy down the way, you know how it goes. I heard that our processing plant in town was up to its old tricks, hiring people who couldn't afford to quit and treating them beyond bad.
Honey, that's just capitalism.
Locking them in to meet quotas and such. I asked Clara. She denied, naturally. But it made her so mad, I asked. I had to go check it out myself. I went in the middle of the night, and right away I saw it was true. The exit was padlocked, right in plain view of the world, and no one cared. I broke in. That's true. I was furious. I broke one of the big machines. That's true, too. So there it is. I stood up, and boy, did I get knocked down.
You must be pretty mad at Clara.
You don't even know the half of it.
I'd better get going.
Get on out of here now. Turns out I am interested, looks like. What you need?
Goodbye.
Bye.
That's better. Get on out of here now. All right, calm down, buddy. Hi. That's not creepy at all. At all.
Better get going.
Goodbye.
That sounds like it's coming from upstairs.
Do we have to go look?
Hello.
Wade said you're the reason he went to jail. Is that true?
No. Wade is the reason Wade went to jail.
He said you were the one who pressed charges.
Well, isn't he the chatterbox when it suits him?
Yes, follow the creepy humming.
Yeah, it is.
Sure, that will lead to something.
What he doesn't get, what no one gets, is that I meant well. No matter how he explained it to you, he broke the law. He broke into the factory, he damaged thousands of dollars of equipment, and scared the workers half to death. I didn't think he'd go to jail, though. And he knows that.
What did you think would happen?
I thought community service. An officer to keep him away from his crooked friends so he would finally straighten up. I planned on dropping the charges, but once the ball got rolling, I lost control of it. Wade ended up sitting across from a judge who wanted to make an example. And that was that. Wade has wanted his revenge ever since. It's stupid. I even suspected him of taking Jessalyn to get back at me. But he'd never do something like that. I mean, I don't think.
I've heard about the ghost, but can you tell me anything about the real Charlotte?
My cousin. But everyone thought we were sisters. She died here. Joined the old family, as they used to say. When I was a little girl, my mama used to say, after we Thornton's passed, we'd keep on living right here. Every night would be a beautiful ball with songs and cute boys to dance with. She wasn't trying to scare me to death, but nonetheless, I did not sleep well on story nights.
It does sound a little eerie.
That was back when Thornton Hall was pretty. Now, I don't even want to entertain the thought.
Did your mother say much else about the ghosts here?
Too much. If she thought there was a ghost about, she'd fall to pieces being so sad.
Sad? Most people are afraid of ghosts.
She had this weird belief that Thornton ghosts aren't around forever. They got a short time to make their peace. If they don't, they get bitter, real mean and nasty. Until they forget everything that made them human. And then they slip into the cracks of the world to live with the others.
The others?
The lost souls. From an accident that happened here years back. Mama called them hungry shadows.
Why?
Shadows.
I don't want to know.
Oof.
She said they were all tangled together, lost and scared and mean. My mama was a good woman. But dang, if she didn't scare me half to death with irregularity.
I bet.
Yeah, no, I can see that.
See you later, hon.
See you later, hon. Sure. Alright, well, let's go follow the creepy singing.
Make yourself blind. Call
Charlotte. Bam.
This means
even ghosts have their favorite haunts. Charlotte requests a meeting with you. Recite a rhyme with dreadful meter where dreadful meter is at its peak. Make yourself blind, don't dare peek. Call Charlotte home and hear her speak. She may just let you live. Not quite sure what that means, though I have a theory that we're going back to.
What's up?
Do you know where the spookiest place in the house is?
No, I'm still trying to find the least spooky place on the property.
I mean, you and
Goodbye.
Me both.
Bye.
I think it's the dock where you can leave.
Hello.
What I would
Goodbye.
Say.
Bye.
You sure do like creeping around.
Oh, there's so much to talk to you about these guys. It's all like exposition.
Special. Just like our Jesslyn. She had the most beautiful voice. When she sang, it was like sunlight busting through fog.
Sounds like you were close.
She was the talented one of the bunch. You can still hear her sing if you stop to listen in the quiet, dark places.
Clara told me that she never intended for you to go to jail.
Don't believe that.
Why not?
Because it ain't true. She used to come visit just to laugh at me through the glass. That was the price of hearing about home.
What happened to Charlotte and Harper's parents?
Plane crash.
Seems like there's a lot of misfortune in the family.
Bad blood brings bad luck.
See you later.
Adios.
Ugh. God. Oh, she looked at me. That's cool. Cute. Well, Boogie's place in the house must be wherever that hits red, I'm guessing. This is what I would say is it's in the house personally. I mean, look at this.
That's almost off the charts. This must be the place.
There it is.
Can't check that off yet.
Okay, how do we make ourselves blind? Blindfold? How do we get a blindfold? Clean napkin, that might work. The fire is warm, the night is cold. I can't see through this blindfold. Here, ghost, come here.
Fire so red, night so black. Dear sweet Charlotte, please come back. What's going on? Where are you taking me?
Tell me, who are you?
Nancy, I'm here to help Jesslyn.
Give me a reason to let you live. Mind you, a good one.
What?
One reason to spare you. Give it to me now. The spirits are growing impatient with my mercy.
You can't scare me. Help me find Jesslyn or get out of the way.
Very good.
I have a hammer. I will fucking use it.
Just who are you?
Harper, can I trust you? Can you be trusted?
Well, that depends. Can you be trusted?
That's a no now, isn't it? You'll be wanting to know why I am hiding under the house.
That would be at the top of my list of questions, yes.
It's because I don't want anyone up there to find me.
Why not?
It is undeniably frigid here. Cold as the crypts themselves. I'll build a fire, and the fire will build some smoke, and the smoke will build some rain.
Are you ignoring my question?
Not ignoring, no. Elongating the moments in between the asking and the hearing, pausing for effect.
Okay. Could you tell me now?
A moment, hon. It's because I'm a grandly unbalanced sociopath. With delusions of grandeur and a history of erratic behavior and violent tendencies. My family resents me. They have publicly said that I am a freak. People in the town point and stare. The neighborhood children used to call me Witch Lady until my dedication to the ironic led me to bake cookies for the sweet darlings. But it was my love of the dramatic reversal that won out in the end, and I threw the little runts down a well.
You what?
Oh, I'd never do such a thing. But it would be funny. Not funny, haha, but funny. Ah! Help, I'm in a well! So that's me. Tell me about you.
I like her.
I bet you're fascinating.
I...
Oh, wait, shut it. I forgot the most important thing. Do
oh,
not
wait, shut
tell
it.
Anyone I am down here. If you do, I'll just do something rotten. Here, take this. Go now.
All right. Well.
I should look for those portraits.
Look to the portraits. That's safe. Sure. Something on the portrait that I'm not seeing. This is IV right there. It's a 4. Oh, maybe that's because it's number 4. I have to find number 1. Woo! Sure. Sounds good. That's number two. Six. Here's number one. Jeb, why won't you let me? Oh, wait.
The letters must be what that note was referring to. All right, now to find all the others.
Aha. I'm a bit of an idiot. It's fine. Also, that's not cleaner, that's turpentine. It's very different than cleaner. Wait, there's none in there. Stairs. Up the stairs. In the haunted house. Very good. This one doesn't have anything. Oh, wait, that one, right there in the middle. Oop.
That's it. Now I should be able to figure out what the code means.
Okay. Something scales. Cotton gin gets seeds. Balance.
That's it.
Because I definitely know how to work a cotton gin. That's fine. Oh, she's still not here. Oh, nobody's here. Okay. The lights out and everything. What time is it? What the fuck? There is no time.
How do I get this working again? I need to put the combs on first.
Okay. This is gonna be fun. Oh, I see. Okay. Obviously not this one. I'm gonna try the one with the least number of bobs.
Fixed it.
Okay. Oh, it just goes.
Done. That's all of the seeds.
Balance scales.
I have to find a way to balance these scales.
Well, that worked. This is going remarkably smooth.
That looks new. It might be Jessalyn's.
Oh, I'm just gonna eat that. That's fine. Wedding notes. Okay. Crazy requests are not mine. Show up and wear a suit. Follows the list of man from on the high. Also tell your mom that I'm fine doing whatever. She's got to go toe-to-toe with my mom about any changes she will. Trust me, let's try not to be near that. Your groomsmen. No beards or piercings or tattoos, and they should all be wearing the exact same shade of black. This is not going to happen since I made the mistake of having friends with personalities. No wedding DJ. It has to be a band and not Brian's band. No one likes wedding DJs. I already told Brian his band could play. They'll behave this time. I'll make sure of it. Table cards. Go talk to my mom about this. She'll make you pick out which ones you like. Pick the second set she shows you. If you pick the first or last, she'll assume you weren't paying attention. It doesn't matter what you pick, but I doubt that you care. Do not care at all. My mom wants a mix. Wants to mix all the guests up at the wedding so people mingle. It's up to you to stop that from happening. Nobody likes that because it's a stupid idea. Looking forward to that. She's going to try to get you to force me to uninvite a few of my friends. Obviously not going to. When she tries, just say, I'll try, but you know how Jess gets. Why can't you deal with this yourself? Why all of this stuff about your mom? Does she realize I'm not marrying her, right? Past. Cucumber tea and sandwiches. Caramelized onion pecan tart, quail egg and caviar over scallop mousseline, filled strawberry soup and a balsamic clouded etched ice ramekin. Molecular gastronomy. Pecan encrusted trout with greens and new potatoes, braised short rib, poached peach fried, yam tartine. I don't know. Some of this, why not fried chicken and cheesy shrimp grits or mac and cheese, honey? I'm going to be honest with you. Like, the chilled strawberry soup sounds pretty good. The braised short rib poached peach fried yam tartine, I'm friggin' down for. And I see something about chocolate pudding served with white something. White pepper? I don't know. This sounds good. I want to eat it.
The Thornton family tree. Hmm. Might come in handy.
You're just gonna leave this here? Yep. Charles' cryptic obsession with Jackson was indeed grave. Was she in search of something lost or lost in the search itself? And who was this Jackson? Dead men tell no tales. You know, that's all that is? No. Colored tiles. Oh, yay. I love colored glass tile puzzles. I love them so much. I didn't offer much of anything.
Speak.
Can you tell me a little more about Clara?
I could, but as a lover of the written word, I prefer show, not tell. So why don't you go ask her about her daddy?
What do you know about Clara?
She's cold. She's a cold person, nothing like Jessalyn. Ask her about Jessalyn. See how she reacts. Not like the caring mom she's pretending to be. Not if you really look.
Were you and Clara close as children?
I don't want to talk about it.
You don't have to go into it.
Should I even have to? Look at me down here, and she's up there. I try not to hate her, but I can't help it.
Can you tell me more about Charlotte?
If I didn't love her so much, I would hate her beyond the great beyond.
Why?
Golden child, Charlotte. She was perfect in everyone's eyes, even mine. I wanted to be her when I grew up. But then one day I was older than my older sister. And older still today.
Why are you here?
Jessalyn, poor little Jessie Lamb has vanished, they say. Can't have that. Not here. No, no, not on the island.
Why not here?
No! I won't let the workers have her.
Workers?
They won't rest, and they want Jessalyn just like they took
Took who?
Don't you worry. You can't have her! You have taken enough!
Do you really believe in the ghost?
Her name is Charlotte, and I've seen her. She's spoken to me.
What exactly did her ghost say?
Boo. Now, my fault she's a stickler for convention. She also says, get out. Oh, right, almost forgot. She says that she hates you and she wants you to leave.
This house is pretty run down. Are you sure it's safe to use that furnace?
No.
Maybe you should not use it? You could be filling the house with fumes.
Sounds like upstairs people problems to me. I'm downstairs people.
Clara came to live with you after her mom died. Is that right?
Yes.
Did you get along?
Yeah, we was a regular Tom and Huck to start.
What do you think
kind of
great.
Wade?
The
You're
Wade
right.
man of Alcatraz. Don't trust him about a single thing in this living world. The world of the dead, he understands that.
Tell me about Charlotte.
She was my big sister.
Do you really think she's...
I know.
How do you know?
No, no more. When Char died, that was the end of my family. I was left completely alone. All I have to call home are those memories. If I share them, they won't be mine anymore.
I'm sorry I asked.
You just didn't know what you were asking.
I lost my mom when I was a girl.
Oh, then you must be an expert on everything.
But sharing my memories of her always made her seem closer, not further away.
You've seen her? What they've made her into? You think I want her closer? And people think I'm crazy. You're crazy. Gone with you. Go now.
Oh, all right. Dust her off. Well, there's this tunnel here. Why not? Right?
Looks like it's missing a piece.
Or not, actually.
Hmm. That's done.
Alright, well, not that way then. Y'all got any nails down here? Like, just nails. That's it. Nails. Where are the nails? Hmm. Right then. Still nothing. I don't even know what this is. Ooh, God, every fucking time. Ugh, can we stop with the small shadow movements? It's just fucking
Hello.
Too much.
Can you tell me anything about your father that might be relevant?
Why would you ask me about my father?
You know, no stone unturned, pursue all angles.
I don't believe you. Fine. I never knew who my daddy was. Happy to hear me say that?
I
promise
don't
I didn't
care.
Know.
Whatever. It doesn't matter.
Happy to hear me say that? I don't really care, dear.
Why didn't your mother ever tell you?
I think one day she was gonna tell me. But she didn't live to get the chance.
There's a strange woman in the basement.
What? That can't be right.
I swear, Harper was there.
Nancy, I've got enough to deal with. Stop playing games, or I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
No, she left. All right. Well. Sure. I have no idea where those nails are. I, like, need those nails.
Hello.
Can you tell me a little about Harper? It seems like you two really didn't get along.
She blamed me for what happened to Charlotte.
Blamed you?
On some level, she was convinced it was me. I let it go at first. She was just torn to shreds about the whole thing. But the more time went by, the more disturbed she got. She was obsessed with the idea that I had stolen part of Charlotte's locket.
What kind of locket?
I never figured out what she was talking about. One night, she followed me out onto the widow's walk. When I got near the railing, she pushed, and I fell. By the time I got out of the hospital, she was gone. I can't say I wasn't relieved.
Harper really was down there. I'm not making things up.
What do you want from me?
Nothing. I just want to find Jessalyn, like you.
Then no more games now, okay?
I'm telling the truth.
Nancy, enough. Just go away.
This is a family.
Hi.
Do you know much about Harper?
I heard she's in some psych hospital or something. But that's all I know. I saw her around once in a while when I was a kid, but I don't remember much.
Did Jessalyn ever say anything about her?
Just that she seemed scared of her. Maybe they had a past, but I don't know.
I'd better get going.
Later.
Hi.
Do you know anything about Harper?
Just what I've heard from Jessalyn. Apparently she handed in her sanity card a while back. Jess said Clara was always worried Harper would return.
Why?
I think she was scared of her. She told Jess to call the police if she ever saw Harper.
I'd better get going.
All right. Later.
All right, let's catch up Beds and Nedstifer.
Hi, Nancy.
Oh, Nedithin.
There's something strange about Jessalyn's disappearance.
Oh, honey, you're
What's
just
that?
Figuring
There's
that out
no
now?
There's no ransom note.
That does complicate things. But I've read
That's
that most
strange.
Missing person cases involve the immediate family.
You're right. I guess the best move is to keep the family talking.
That is not
maybe
hard. They do not stop talking.
Or maybe they're trying to tell you something.
How so?
Remember in Kyoto, you told me that ghosts are what people invent when an injustice can't be fixed?
Sounds me-ish.
If that's the case here, once you figure out what the deal with the ghost is, I bet it'll point right to Jessalyn. And if the ghost is real, then case closed. A ghost did it. If that turns out to be the case, please don't tell me. I like living in a world where ghosts are probably not real.
You know
I already have to fall
both.
Into the bed after every scary movie for fear of ankle grabbers.
I met Wade.
I still say giving your child a verb for a name dooms them to a life of hearing mediocre jokes. What's he like?
He's got a bit of a rough edge. He seemed surprised that I came instead of Savannah.
What do you mean?
He wanted Savannah here, specifically.
Why?
I don't know, but I intend to find out. It looks like Clara never knew who her father was.
How sad. Do you think you can figure out who it was?
I don't think that's the important part.
Right. That was just a test question to see if you were still a smart detective. For a further test, please explain why.
She never really got to know her place in the family. I don't know exactly how, but that's a piece of this. It's a case of follow the money. Someone wants what Clara has, or Clara's worried she's going to lose it. Harper keeps avoiding Clara and Wade.
Oh, she is definitely up to something. Keep an eye on her.
I met Harper.
What's she like?
She might be completely crazy. Either that or she wants me to think that's the case.
So, who is she?
She's a Thornton, all right, but that's pretty much all I know. She seems to be hiding from everyone.
Hiding?
For the moment.
You met a weirdo who has an obvious affinity for ghost kidnappings during the course of your investigation of a ghost kidnapping? And you didn't tell anyone? Ned, say something to uncrazy your girlfriend.
Don't be that way?
Not compelling, Ned.
Should I say it like you would?
If that's what it takes.
Nancy, your newfound buddyship with that baddie basement dweller is freaking me out.
I have trained you well. Now go, Nancy. Tattle like the wind.
All right. I think you may have a point. I just saw a ghost.
So what are we talking? Puppet? Mirror tricks?
No. Listen, don't tell anyone else this.
Is this going to be a ghost blind item? A well-known spirit was spotted at a popular haunt canoodling with a certain ghost about town known for his habit of appearing in mirrors.
Can you channel Sirius Bess for a moment?
Okay. Homework, my dad talking about taxes, that picture of a puppy who got lost. Old paintings of European royalty. I'm there.
Thanks. Since I've gotten here, things have been getting stranger and stranger.
Old paintings of European royalty.
I can't shake this feeling. It's like an odd weight. I'm not saying the ghosts are real here. I'm just saying, I don't know what I'm saying.
That doesn't sound like the Nancy I know.
I know. I just need to clear my head. There is always a scientific explanation.
Ned, you gotta tell her to come home.
Still gotta work on that whisper, Bess.
Nancy, you're really scaring me. Come home.
I will, just as soon as I can. See you later.
See ya.
Let's send another email. Okay, let's talk back to Savannah. I love the phone conversations, because they just kind
of
like drag a little bit sometimes.
You've
especially
done a lot
when
of research on the Thornton family,
you know,
right?
Talking to
what have you found?
This Ned.
Like a lot of powerful families around here, they were forged in the Civil War. Like every war, it was a brutal thing that made a lot of men dead and a couple of men rich. Or women, in this case. The family matriarch, the Gray Lady. They say she was a spy for the North.
Is that true?
Could be. She kept records like a spy for show. Which is to say she didn't. One thing's known. She fed the North troop positions that turned the tide of more than one battle. She was compensated quite well for it. The island itself was a gift. She was either a traitor or a spy. That's why the Northerners got to calling her Gray Lady. If you ask me, she started a nasty thought and tradition. Success at the cost of innocent blood. Anyone who tries to write things in that family gets ostracized or worse.
What happened to your old assistant, Logan?
He fired me.
Doesn't it usually work the other way?
You'd think so. He got fed up with me.
Why?
He gave me an ultimatum. Write the draft or he'd find someone else to work for. I do not do ultimatums.
Tell me what happened when you met Charlotte.
I'll tell you, hon. But you got to remember that you are not like me.
What do you mean?
I have opened the door to the spirit world, and you have not. And don't you dare do it, ever. You hear?
Yeah, I can agree to that.
I mean it. The dead are just like lost children. If you're out there leaving a trail of breadcrumbs, they will find you. Enough of the PSA. I snuck out there to the bones on the anniversary of her death. I waited in silence for a long time. Nothing.
You didn't say the rhyme?
Oh, that? Oh, it's cute, but I wasn't looking for my daddy's brain-dead bloodhound. They come when they come, and in the dead of night, she came. Stood right beside me. Just me and her, eye to eye, for a hot minute. Finally, she reached for my wrist. She pulled me through a fog that became smoke and then fire. She pulled me back to the night she died.
Could you see what happened that night?
I couldn't see a thing. I could only feel the heat. I could feel how sad she was and how angry. I'm sorry, hon. Talking about it don't come easy.
I'm just trying to fit the pieces together. What does Charlotte have to do with Jesselyn?
All families got one thing in common. Every generation, just like the last. There's some rebels and some oddballs that break the mold. But for the most part, one generation gonna follow into the footsteps of the next. From what I gathered, Jesselyn seems to be cut from the same cloth as Charlotte. You ask me, if someone saw Charlotte as a threat, then Jesselyn's been born behind enemy lines.
You said you opened the door to the spirit world. What did you mean?
You really sure you want to know?
I'm curious, and no disrespect, but...
Last time, I told you how my daddy got me interested in ghosts, but that's only part of the story. When I was young, there was a spot in my room where I could fold back the wallpaper. There was this gorgeous old wood behind it. I mean, to me it was. I'd trace the ripples in the grain with my finger for sometimes hours.
Why?
I don't know. I was a girl, and it was the only thing I knew about that no one else did. I don't know exactly when it started, but I began to trace a beautiful old willow into the wall over and over again. Strong limbs running up to the sky and the tangled roots grabbing tight at the dirt. I was obsessed. I traced the tree until I knew every detail. I even started to see it after a time, little indentations in the wood. But one day, the lines felt strange and cold. And I realized it wasn't the wall I was feeling. There was a girl on the other side of the wood. She was showing me what to draw. She was trying to tell me something. I should have shut my eyes tight and glued the paper back. But I didn't, and I couldn't. I let her teach me the shape of the tree again and again until one day I saw it in real life.
What happened?
Not a thing until a strong storm hit a few months later. I don't have to tell you what they found when they... pulled what was left of the willow tree from the ground, now do I? That's when I decided I would learn to listen. I knew even then it had come at a cost. I just had no idea how high.
Goodbye.
Well, that was a lovely story. Now that we're done with it, let's get back to this mystery that will hopefully have nails in it.
You sure do like creeping around.
God, there's so much
talking. Do you think that what happened to Charlotte was an accident?
Dunno. The night before, I saw her take off into the night holding this little package like it was precious to her. The look on her face. I should have stopped her, said, "What is wrong? Here, take this."
Is this Charlotte's?
Yes.
Do you know what this is? Can you tell me what it's for?
Maybe that's enough for now.
Did Clara get along with Charlotte and Harper when she was younger?
They all got along famously, until the night of the fire.
What exactly happened?
Charlotte was getting ready for her big 21st birthday ball, and at the last minute went off to what is now the ruins. No one knows what started the fire.
After that, what about Clara and Harper?
Clara grew up pretty fast, but Harper, she got lost in that night. Never got found.
I swear, Harper was there.
I told you. Life don't play by the rules here. Anyways, if she was, she ain't now.
See you later.
Adios.
Can you please not destroy the Spanish language like that? Adios. It's adios. Ah, sound. Ah. Thanks.
Hi.
See you later.
Goodbye.
He's not a racist, I promise. Right? Again? Push glass vessels and find me in below. C before I before K, N immediately before B, F neither first nor fourth, K after N, I is third. All right, well, take a look at that in a minute. Oh, that's creepy. Nice. I'm getting chills already. This is great. Woo! Let's go open it, right?
The key fits, but I think it's broken.
Well, that's that. Ooh, okay. Oh, I scare so easily.
Nancy.
See you later.
Take care.
I need to follow the instructions from the note.
Okay. Look closer at this note again. C before I before K. I is third. 1, 2, 3, and that is I. I only know that. I haven't written down, like, by the way. This is a game that I haven't really needed to. Everything's either written down for me or you just talk to people over and over again. A after M. F is neither first nor fourth. Okay. N is immediately before B. C is before I, before K. F neither first nor fourth. A after N. K is after N. N has to be directly before B. I has to be third, though. Huh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because the other thing is that whether this spells out a word. That seems to work. C-F-I-N-B-K. It doesn't spell a word, but it works. N is directly before B. C is before I, which is before K. And N is before K. Let's try that, I guess. B-C. B-E-F. B-H-I. A-K-L-M. N E F I J K. Well, it opened. So.
What was I supposed to think? One day you were just gone.
I should listen.
Lexi.
Lexi.
And I hope you understand how much that makes me hate you right now.
Who is Lexi?
That's it. That's all we get here. No nails. Ugh. No.
What's happening? I
better get some rest.
No offense, but you sound really tired.
Been burning the midnight oil at both ends?
Feels like it. I must have slept through the day. But I still feel exhausted.
Maybe you should pace yourself a bit.
I know. Wait, hang on.
Hang on? Why? Is there a ghost?
No, I see something. Call you back later.
Oh. Flower is a joy when it thrives, a burden when death arrives. Gather your dried petals where immortality resides. Place a flower where she stands before the stone turns to dust. She will tell you what she can, away and back to her trust. Use here.
Pretty upset.
Nancy.
Goodbye.
All right,
take care.
We're just not going to talk about that? All right, sure. Not going to talk about that.
We could have found a way.
It's Colton. I better listen.
Lexi.
Now we're back here again. About me.
I want to see you when this is all over.
Oof.
I know. All I said is I want to see you. Then why did you pick up the phone? Just see me.
It sounds like he's talking to Lexi.
Hey. Did you listen in on my call?
Who is Lexi?
What are you talking about?
The girl
Sweetie
you're
honey,
on the phone with?
This is the second
time. You don't know
time.
What you heard. You understand me?
I think she is someone important to you.
I don't want to talk about it.
Your fiancé is missing, and the way you're talking to this Lexi...
You want a conversation? Fine. I love Lexi. I want to spend my life with her.
You're engaged.
That was based on a lie. Clara, my parents, even Jessalyn. They were all in on it.
Jessalyn? Are you sure?
She'd have to be. I mean, I haven't considered that she might not be yet. Before Jess and I got together, I was with Lexi. Until one day she called and said it was over. She wouldn't even see me. Then, she was gone. And now I find out. My parents pushed her away, and Clara pushed me and Jess together. Mom and Dad wanted a piece of the Thornton fortune, and Clara wanted a piece of the Birchfield influence. So excuse me for being conflicted. I want Jesslyn safe, but...
I still don't understand what's going on. Why are you here?
To try to forget something.
Forget what?
I guess it must have worked.
So, things would really work out for you if Jessalyn just disappeared.
Do you really want to ask me that?
Sorry, I just really want to figure out where she is.
Trust me, so do I.
Why is Lexi so important?
I've always felt a little out of step with the world. When I met Lexi, it's like everything snapped into place. I don't know how else to put it.
And it wasn't the same with Jessalyn?
I do love her. But not in the way I tried to. Jess is my best friend, and always will be. If she ever comes home, and if she ever forgives me.
You don't think Jesslyn's coming back, do you?
What are you implying?
Nothing. Just observing.
You want to know the truth so bad? Yeah, I'm afraid she's never coming back. Happy? Can't stay away.
Nope.
Where do you go when you're not out here?
Pound every single thing.
Nowhere.
So, every once in a while you pop out of existence?
I walk around, looking for Jesslyn.
Aren't you worried that your parents won't approve of Lexi?
Not after all they've done. It's time for them to stop worrying about my approval. Because I am done looking for theirs.
See you later.
Goodbye.
Hello.
Colton thinks he was forced into the relationship with Jessalyn.
Forced? Please. Jessie's a gem. Any man be lucky to get the time of day from her. Don't tell a soul about this, But Colton, he's got problems. Nothing big, so don't go jumping to conclusions. But his parents told me right away he's always struggled a little. He's a smart boy, but these fits of paranoia take hold of him now and again.
Did that ever worry you, considering he was dating your daughter?
Very convenient accusation to make at this given moment, just saying.
I'm saying give him some space. He's had his troubles.
Goodbye.
See you later, hon.
You scared me.
Ha. See you later.
Get on out of here now.
Why are you so mean about that? Fuck off.
This looks like the picture from the camera.
Well, let's go to the burned out ruin where Charlotte died. This is gonna go fine. Hey, bats. Where's the, No? Fine.
The numbers along the edges should help me arrange the tiles correctly.
Okay. Okay. This is, all in the wrong hands. You find this and don't know what it is. Please, I'm begging you to put it back and hide it well. If you know who I am, then this will help you understand what I did. Arrange the color pairs. Orange and blue numbers along the sides indicate how many of that color in the corresponding row or column. Important, two squares the same color can't be directly next to each other. Use the XX to mark pairs you know contain neither color. Okay, so they have to... Yeah, they have to be pairs. Boom, 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 boom. Weird. The highest number on here is 4. Tough. Oh no, actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, no. Never mind. Okay. Thought they could be right next to each other. Either has to be that or the other way around. Boing, 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 boing. Very annoying. Not gonna lie. This is possible to put... No, see, I can't do that because... next to each other, so how do I... Unless that's reversed. That has to be reversed. Have to be. Okay, that has to be the way that works then. Okay. Oof. This is a... bit of a brain scratcher puzzle, not gonna lie. Okay, that says two, so it must be one of these two. This one is all full of reds. I'm gonna put it there. That's right. That's the only way that works. Okay. Can't be there. Can't be there, so it has to be here. Only way that works. Means there has to be a red here. Et voila! Hmm. Alright, well. We did the puzzle part. Let's do the scary part now. By going into the house. Yep.
Just my imagination.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Okay, let's just go in. This is fine. This is totally fine. Totally fine.
There's something down there.
Worked better than I thought it would. Is that all we have to do out here? I'm cool if that's all we gotta do. Now let's go into the crypt. God, it just doesn't get any better, does it?
Can't check that off. Still can't check that off yet.
I can't check any of those off. It's fine.
You sure do like creeping around.
Do you believe in ghosts?
Creeping?
I don't need belief.
Why not?
I have proof. EVP. Hear some creepy things from time to time. Check it out whenever you want, if you got the nerve.
What made you call Savannah?
Jessalyn didn't run away when she was kidnapped.
Please tell me you've seen meeting Chris Fleming's thing on Phantom of the Opera in his boat, because it's excellent. You know, they say that the best day of your life is the day you get the boat, and the second best day of your life is the day you get rid of the boat. Christine! Oh, sorry, no, I thought I saw someone that I knew. It was just one of my giant candelabras.
Savannah seemed to think you'd be disappointed she didn't come here. Any reason why?
Savannah's talking to you about me?
Yeah, she's helping you with a case.
Don't suppose you could give me your number?
This sounds like a privacy concern. This sounds like a privacy concern. I don't know that I feel comfortable giving out numbers like that.
I don't think she'd want that.
So she told you.
Told me?
We, she and I were something of a couple.
It was fucking obvious.
Been a long time since we talked.
I think you're just trying to scare me away.
Girl?
Nancy.
Girl?
Girl. Fear ain't some feeling to overcome, especially not here. That prickly feeling you get in that old house, that means something dark is whispering your name.
Also, you just mean that it's dark. A cold
Trust
house.
Me. That's as close as you want to get.
Girl!
Get on out of here now.
Can I still slap him? Just a little... You say that like it's a bad thing.
I had
you're
to come
one.
Out here because of you.
I still don't understand why you're hiding.
You don't know who these people are. You think you know who to trust, but you don't.
I trust you.
You do? Then don't tell anyone where I am. But just so you know, you shouldn't trust me either. I don't have your best interests at heart.
You're looking for something in here, aren't you?
Keep your voice down. Do you want me to be found?
No.
Then shh. Use your inside of a crypt voice.
Ba-dum-psh.
Get away.
All right.
Can't do that right now.
What are you doing? Get out of there.
Alright, apparently I can't do anything.
Get away!
Can't do that right now.
Alright, do I just like...
Hi.
I'd better get going.
Later.
I have a... Okay, there we go. He's gone now. Da-da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da-da.
Important.
Yes, it does.
If I can match the colors on the sides of each piece, I should be able to get this back in order.
Oh. Oof. Okay. Right. Oh, they automatically spin based on where. Oh, damn it. Oh, that makes it hard. what's wrong. And nothing goes there? That doesn't make sense. Oh, right, because this doesn't, that doesn't necessarily go there. That obviously must be what goes there then, because nothing works. And that's the only thing that goes there. Which means this has to go here. So, ooh. Oh, it has to be this. Okay. So this all fits. Kind of work from there slowly. Possibilities here. Let's work over here. A couple of possibilities there too. That's the most obvious. That's the only one that works. Not fit. Go. Do something different. Can't be that one. So. That one. Which now that all works. So keep going. I get the feeling that the letters should be right side up here. They're all right side up over here so far, except for that is. I think it's a D though, maybe? Oh, that might work. Does it? And then it's.
Beauregard.
Where was that?
I should find out what design I need to make first. Something is missing. There must be something that will show me what shape opens the coffin.
Ah, we found the bird one. Okay. Not quite right. Not quite right. Which noises? The ones that the coffins made? This does not want to work for me, huh? How do I get this one in? That's the question. That's what I'm struggling with for some reason. And then once I get it, I need to, yeah. There we go. Let me just borrow that from you. Sorry. There we go. Let me do anything with the flower, though. Well, we have new things to try out on the fountain. Or not? Not. Come on.
Mentioned you had some paranoia issues in the past. Is that true?
All these people about these problems.
I've had to fight for it.
That's not paranoia, that's
that
depression.
Involved seeing a psychiatrist for a bit when I was a kid. Clara knows why I went. But still won't let it go.
Goodbye.
Bye. But that's okay.
Nancy,
I found a reel of film you might want to see. Do you have anything to play it with?
There's an old projector somewhere.
I saw Charlotte.
Pretty scary, isn't it?
Yeah, you could say that. Still, there must be some sort of explanation.
You might be right.
Just what?
I don't know. This old house is playing tricks on my head.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. Still haven't been able to get onto her phone, though. Oh, all right. Oh, Jesus.
Why would you play that? Turn it off now.
I'm sorry. That's creepy. I didn't mean to upset you with the movie.
I know, but just give me a minute. Seeing that just, well, it made my head hurt worse. I keep seeing it when I close my eyes.
Woo!
Nancy.
I'd better get going.
Take care.
Well, I know where that's in the film. We gotta go back into the house where Charlotte died, which I love. Yep, there's another one. Cool. God, I love these. Dead.
What happened? If I can stack enough things together, maybe I could climb up to that wallpaper.
Wonk. Okay. I don't know why Her Interactive decided to start with these puzzles. I'll take a wild guess and say that's not a good idea. This is safe. This is totally fucking safe.
This must be about that star sketch. I should copy the image down.
Well, two handles pull out the box to which the star belongs. From the middle, it shines, rising above the wall.
Whoa, that was close.
Okay, two handles pull out the box to which the star belongs. From the middle, it shines, rising above them all. Two handles on the coffin. Yeah, Nancy doesn't weigh anything. I just need more plates.
Hi there.
I saw the ghost.
You did? You don't look near as bad as most who see her.
I'm not scared of ghosts.
Yeah, that's a lie.
She terrifies everybody.
I'd better get going.
Adios.
That's every time you say it.
Hi.
Did you ever meet Charlotte?
Yeah, I did. The girl, not the ghost.
Can you tell me anything about her?
Everyone loved her and everyone wanted her attention. But she still made time for me. She was a rare person. She just loved the world. Loved her family, living or dead.
Or dead?
Jess told me Charlotte used to spend time in the crypt because she couldn't stand the idea of anyone ever being forgotten.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Clara?
I saw Charlotte, and she looked mad.
Are you sure it was Charlotte and not someone dressed up like her?
She walked right through the wall, and she told me something only I could possibly know.
What?
I said, it's something only I could possibly know.
Not to be rude, but you don't look so great right now.
Headache. I think it's the stress. Since I got here, I have been feeling really strange.
See you later.
See you later, hon.
Oh, look. It's little old you. Where's the cavalry?
Why are you still hiding? What's to stop me from telling everyone where you are?
Maybe I'm the only one who can help find Jessalyn. Did you ever think of that?
All right, I won't tell. Clara said you had a troubled childhood. Is that true?
Troubled? No, I was an angel. And I must have been quite the genius charmer, too, because one day they shipped me off. Straight to the most elite private boarding school on the East Coast. At least that's what I believed was happening, until we were creeping up the long and whirly black driveway, and I caught my first glimpse of the bars on the windows. I became the first Thornton to be admitted to the Millicent P. Krauthammer Sanitarium for criminally insane girls and women of good social standing. I'm one of the few girls to actually graduate from that program. I got a little diploma that says Harper's no longer a danger to herself or others and everything. And just yesterday, the Alumni Association sent me one of them dried macaroni pictures inviting me to speak at a function. But as you can see, I am otherwise engaged.
Where do you live when you're not here?
Wouldn't you like to know? And wouldn't I like to know?
I really upset Clara, thanks to you.
Did she cry? And if she did, was it one stoic little tear like she was going for one of the movie awards? Or was it a big, snuffly, ugly cry? Oh, she's an ugly cryer. I hate to bring that to the table, but it is the truth.
You made me upset a woman whose daughter is missing.
Oh, she's a big girl now. The truth shouldn't upset her. Don't look at me like that. I'm bored down here, and she's done worse to me.
Are you the one writing the notes I keep finding?
What answer do you want me to say? Are you looking for a yes or a no? Or the in-between one?
Just the truth.
Oh, now that I can't help you with. I don't function well in reality.
Do you know I see an old film of Charlotte's birthday would upset Clara that much?
Did it upset her?
Quite a bit.
Oh, I wish I could have seen it. Reenact it for me now. You be Clara. Show me what happened.
I really don't want to do that.
Spoil sport. What was even the point then?
Did you leave that out for me to find?
No. Maybe.
Why?
Because I want her to be sad every single day of her miserable little life. And I had a hunch it would be funny. Was I right?
No.
Yeah, I was. You just don't want to say it.
Why did your family send you away?
Why don't you ask your beloved Clara?
Enough. You have to tell me what you're doing.
You don't tell me enough. It doesn't work that way. When it's time to find out, you'll find out. I promise you. Promise.
You're dressing up as Charlotte or doing something to fake these hauntings, aren't you?
The hits keep coming. You're a doll, a real peach. Ew! Oh, you're not kidding, are you? Am I dressing up as my dead sister for kicks? After the only family member everyone can agree on has gone missing? Is that what you're asking?
Yes, that's the question. The implication was more or less added by you.
No, I am not, so shut it! Don't want to go in the house? Don't blame you.
I'd better get going.
Goodbye!
Did that. Check. Haven't done that.
That. another secret passageway. Cool. A lot of secret passageways in this house. Oh. Up here? Yep. Well, that was that. Back down.
Speak.
I'd better get going.
Yes, leave.
Okay, so we just need to find whatever that dirt is here. And that.
This looks like one of the pictures from Jessalyn's camera.
There yeah, I kind of figured that before we picked the camera up, or once we picked the camera up, but you know. Well, I don't have a key, so. Well, now that I can actually explore this, can I go anywhere else? No. Ooh! What the fuck was that?
Better copy this design.
First of its kind across the bottom. Well, I found one. Just something. And? How did that all work? That didn't work. Weird, it just isn't working. Okay, well, moving on. Yes.
Check. Can't check. Haven't done that.
Hey.
I'd better get going.
Goodbye.
Alright guys, I'm gonna probably call it at this point, because I'm both lost and tired. So, I'm not gonna write down notes for this. I will probably be back on Thursday. Oh, I do not need to save, I already did. And there we go. Okay. I'm going to call it here for the night, because I'm tired and I got to go to bed and I got to go to work tomorrow. So, yeah, well, thank you guys for coming to watch the stream again. I'll probably be streaming again this week, probably on Thursday. Keep an eye out for that. I'll make an announcement on social media and on my Discord as usual. And, yeah. That's okay. You don't have to say anything. Just come in and watch and hang out. That's totally fine. But thank you guys for coming. And yeah, I guess I'll see you later this week. And we'll finish up Thornton Hall. Have a good night, guys. Take care.